Sandro Botticelli was an Italian painter of the early Renaissance. He was born in 1445 and died in 1510 at age 64. Botticelli belongs to the Florentine school under the patronage of Lorenzo de' Medici. He painted a wide range of religious subjects and also some portraits. But Sandro Botticelli is most known for his mythological subjects such as Primavera and Birth of Venus. They both are located in the Uffizi Gallery in Florence. Today, I'll be talking about Birth of Venus. Birth of Venus is a painting that was created in the mid-1480s during Italian Renaissance. It displays the goddess Venus arriving at the shore after her birth, where she emerged from the sea fully grown. But who is Venus? She is the goddess of love, sex, beauty, and fertility. Venus was a part of Roman mythology, but she is also the counterpart to the Greek Aphrodite. Aphrodite was born of the foam from the sea after Saturn castrated his father Uranus and his blood fell to the sea. Aphrodite has a magical girdle that compels anyone she wishes to desire her. In simpler terms, Venus is the Roman equivalent to Aphrodite. Venus was married to Vulcan, who was the god of fire, but she also had numerous affairs with gods and mortals. The most notorious affair was with Ares, who was the god of war. The painting you are now seeing is of Venus and Vulcan. Next is a painting of Vulcan catching Venus and Mars having sex. Now it's time for the big finale. As I mentioned earlier, Ares was the ultimate affair that Venus had. This is a sculpture of Ares. He is the god of war. Now, we're back looking at The Birth of Venus by Sandro Botticelli. As I mentioned earlier, this is one of his most iconic images. Venus is fabulously beautiful as she stands, radically naked in a Renaissance painting, not in a Christian context. Until this point in Renaissance, the only time we would see a nude was of Eve. Botticelli portrayed her based on an ancient Roman sculpture of Venus. This painting might have been from one of the Medici court, perhaps the cousin of Lorenzo de' Medici. Venus is born of the sea and seems to be being pushed in by the winds. They are personified on the left. She stands on the seashell. Well, almost stands on the seashell. There's just so much impossibility in this painting. And when she gets to the shore, she'll be received by an attendant that's ready to wrap her new body. There's an extraordinary curve to the body that I believe suggests that she has a very flexible skeletal structure. And even the zephyrs, who are the winds that blow her to the shore, are intertwined in impossible ways. Also, every figure in this painting floats. When we look at Renaissance paintings, we generally expect to see real naturalism. We expect to see features that have weight, with bodies that make sense, existing in a realistic space. Well, that's what we think of when we think about the Renaissance, but that's not what Botticelli gives us. Some art historians have suggested that Botticelli is looking back to ancient Greek painting, and the only painting that Botticelli would have had available to him from the classical Greek tradition would have been vase painting, where figures are often isolated against the ground. All the figures were isolated in this painting. If we take a look back at the Birth of Venus, we can almost imagine each grouping as line painting on a vase. In fact, the painting is really linear, and because of the patterning and quality of the linear, it defies space. Yes, we can look into the deep space, but this is not a Masaccio. The attempt made here is to de-emphasize deep space and to instead create a sense of pattern and beauty. Botticelli is creating a kind of beauty that is a result of course and the narrative. It's a result of elegance of the figure herself. but also through the use of pattern and decorative quality. We can see that, especially in the traces of gold that she's placed in her hair and into the trees to the right. There's a kind of sensuality here that's irresistible. The pink flowers fluttering between Venus and the Zephyr. The beautiful lines that create the waves, hair, and fluttering drapery. It's a beautiful world that anyone would want to enter. Now, let's compare and contrast Primavera and Birth of Venus. They both were painted by Sandro Botticelli. Primavera reveals a strange and ambiguous beauty. It was created for Lorenzo di Pietro. Primavera was created in 1482, while Birth of Venus was created in 1485. Primavera is purely literary and classical. Cupid, Venus, Flora, Spring, and Zephyr are all borrowed from Lucretius. Primavera's strange beauty is individual. The orange stand of trees seem to be an elaborate metal base relief, which was completely unusual for the Florentine art of the period. Critics may prefer Primavera or Birth of Venus. Lovers of the fantastic, essential Botticelli will prefer Primavera for the richness of its contents, the varied impressions it relays, and the general romantic treatment. The more classically inclined will find higher satisfaction in the simpler and more unified impression of the Birth of Venus, and the more advanced and purposeful rendering of the landscape, in its harmony of somber colors of gray, olive, pale, blue, and rose, with fine tracery of gold and the melancholy of the Virgin Goddess. Motion reinforced by the symmetry of color is the main impression one gets from Primavera and Birth of Venus. No other artist among the Renaissance painters had Botticelli's grace and charm, lightness of touch. No one can portray wind and floating draperies and the feeling of air and motion as he does. And it is also the final use of brush in mosses that distinguished Sandro Botticelli from others. Primavera shows an amazing arrangement of line. Botticelli was even named the master of a single line, but he uses it to outline the figure, contour. Everything is done with a unique rhythm. This movement is reinforced by contrast as the shimmering drapery of Flora or the heavy folds of Venus's robes caught against the dancing forms of Graces. Like in all of Botticelli's mature works, we see a magic brush powerfully enhancing the value of expressive contour and dynamic line. The artwork I created is called The Rebirth of Taylor. The picture on the left is a picture of me from sophomore year, and the picture on the right is a photo of me from last year. I created this artwork by creating a collage and combining both pictures together. This was very meaningful to me because this was a changing point in my life. I transformed mentally and physically, and it was the new version of Taylor. This connects to the Birth of Venus because the Birth of Venus is a photo of she being fully grown into a woman, and I feel like this shows me being fully grown into the mature person I am. Now it's time for some challenge questions.